Hello, welcome to Daily News from Merjaiyat TV. Daily meetings of Grand Shia Jurist Ayatollah Shirazi in Holy Qom. The office of the Shia Islamic Jurist Grand Ayatollah Sayyid Sadr Husseini Shirazi in the holy city of Qom hosts crowds of Shia believers from around the world, including religious scholars, clerics, activists, and academics as part of the daily meetings of the Grand Jurist. In these meetings, the visitors offer reports of their activities and listen to pieces of advice by the Grand Jurist. It is worth noting that the daily meetings of the Grand Jurist Ayatollah Shirazi are held every day before noon prayers. Members of Office of Grand Ayatollah Shirazi participate in Arbaeen pilgrimage. On Saturday, 3rd of Safar, coinciding with October 13th, some members of the Office of Grand Ayatollah Shirazi in Basra participated in this year's Arbaeen annual pilgrimage. The members of the Grand Jurist Office set out on an on-foot pilgrimage to the holy city of Karbala, visiting service units and mawkibs along the way of pilgrimage from Basra province to holy Karbala. The directives and guidelines of the Grand Jurist Ayatollah Shirazi were also conveyed to people serving in mawkibs. Representative of Grand Jurist in India demands facilitation of Arbaeen pilgrimage. The representative of the Grand Shia Jurist Ayatollah Shirazi in India, Sayyid Saif Abbas Naghavi, urged the facilitation of Arbaeen pilgrimage in his letter to the Iraqi ambassador in this country. The Grand Jurist representative highlighted the immense love of Shias in India for Imam Hussein and demanded the facilitation for visa fees during the Arbaeen annual pilgrimage. Ayatollah Shirazi Center in Holy Karbala holds conference. Ayatollah Shirazi Center for Strategic Studies in Holy Karbala held a conference under the title of Imam Hussein and Lessons from Ashura. This conference hosted a panel of legal experts, academics, and media activists. Sheikh Murtaza Maash, the director of An-Naba Institute, was one of the speakers at this conference. In his remarks, he said, "We believe that Imam Hussein was trying to continue in the path of his grandfather, the God's holy messenger of Islam, and implement the commands of God. As a result, he initiated a movement to unleash the Muslim society from oppression and dictatorship, both on the inside and on the outside. The human societies always swing between a struggle for freedom and tyranny. It is not always a question of power, but it is mostly about a people who have accepted to be enslaved and oppressed." PR Office of Grand Jurist, we plan unifying services in Arbaeen. A few days ahead of Arbaeen annual pilgrimage, the public relations manager of Grand Shia Jurist Ayatollah Shirazi in Holy Karbala hosted a group of Iraqi chieftains and the secretary of Husseini Mawakib Institute in his office in a bid to solidify relations between all influential figures in Karbala and unify services to pilgrims in the city. In this meeting, all sides emphasized on collaborative works to provide services to the pilgrims of Imam Hussein, peace be upon him, during the Arbaeen annual pilgrimage, which is the world's largest peaceful gathering of people. Nasrullah, the PR manager of Grand Jurist, appreciated the selfless works of all Mawakib in Iraq and underscored the need for devising a plan to increase cooperation and diversity of services in the holy city of Karbala. He then stressed on solidarity among all servants of Imam Hussein, saying that all seditions to disrupt relations between Mawakib have been neutralized. At the end, the PR manager of Grand Ayatollah Shirazi said that he will host more meetings with other Mawakib in Holy Karbala to ensure constructive cooperation during this year's Arbaeen. Director of AhlulBayt Center participates in Baghdad Poet Seminar. Over the past few days, the director of AhlulBayt Center in Baghdad participated in a poetry conference hosted by Baghdad Association of Poets in Al-Karkh District. The conference was attended by groups of local poets, literary figures, and managers of Mawakib and service units in Iraq. In this event, some poems were read in honor of Imam Hussein, peace be upon him.